Retro World, Toys and Games, Episode 1. We might not even keep track, but this one's one. Retro World After Dark. Comments are going to look a little more risque. 18 plus faux show. What else? We're still going to talk toys. We're going to show toys, but we're going to talk everything. We're going to have a slew of special guests, hopefully, coming through. Retro World After Dark. Bradley, be joining me. Say hi.
Hi.
Hi. And, so what we did was last night we actually filmed something. The Retro World After Dark came to fruition more this morning, but we filmed something that would be perfect for it. So we're going to show that to you now as episode one of Retro World After Dark. See those cool graphics I made?
Yeah.
Yeah. We're here in my nautical themed room. We're not in the basement for once. We're not in the dungeon.
It's a miracle.
We're in the fireplace room. There's the fireplace. Nautical thing. Globes. Papa Charlie's radio. Fred Scratchy, the captain head.
And Fred. Hello, Fred.
Hello.
Hi. Hi, Fred. Oh, where you going? What are you doing?
Oh, Fred. Oh, Retro World After Dark. You're going to hear a lot more of the word fuck, which you normally don't hear in our videos. A couple more bullshits and sons of bitches. Yeah. And all the other things. Burger snitch, shot and shit. All that stuff. You're going to see it. Retro World After Dark.
You're going to see shit.
We're basically going to discuss the same shit. We're just going to speak however the fuck we want.
Yeah.
Because he's 18 now, so I could. Retro World. Toys and games. A little follow-up from our unboxing of our... My... Ecto-1, my OnlyFans exclusive sexy swim goggles, my Ninjor action figure, kind of cool, not as cool as the original. I don't think we've ever unboxed an Origins, and we're like, we like it.
Yeah, it's cool.
Except for Scareglow. Scareglow's cool.
Yeah, that one we did.
We have that. Here, hand it to me. We'll show them. I have about several of these laying in various places around the house, just because I love them so much. But yeah, that Scareglow's probably the coolest Origins of the line. I want to show off a couple other things that I had purchased over the last year or so, and I've not found a permanent place behind us yet. I got my Kitty's Trapper Keeper.
I want it.
It's mine. Look, still, remember that sound? People my age, remember that?
I don't remember that.
If you're within the age range of like 40 to 48, you know that sound. Specifically, kitties. Mine. I got my water. What else do we got? Hand me the Wrestling Superstars air freshener.
Coco Beware.
Coco Beware air freshener. Smells just like Coco Beware himself. And the bird. Were you ever in a locker room with him?
Yes.
No, you weren't.
Yeah,
you were a kid and you met him. So you were at the show, you weren't in a locker room.
Yeah,
I sat next to him. The man doesn't smell that bad. The man's all right. So apparently this is going to smell like the Birdman Coco Beware. I haven't opened it yet. Don't want to. It's vintage. What else do we have? Here, watch your head for a second. As you see my Jaws game. Hold on. I can't get the finger thing right. Boom. Jaws the game. I just added the Polar Battle Bear G.I. Joe in the box. Sealed Devilfish. That Devilfish right there. Sealed. Blue Hordak. Is that another Scareglow?
Yes.
I have so many of those. The He-Man portion of my little clutch, my little King Randor. I need some accessories. If anybody out there has King Randor accessories, I'll give you a plug. Get some of those. My Hulk, you see my LGNs? Over there. Like, subscribe, follow. Hurry up, subscribe. My Batman stuff down there. You see some G.I. Joe. Bam, strawberry shortcake. I got all kinds of things. And it continues on all the way down the basement that way. And Ghostbusters and Superpowers. Rocky Balboa that way. I have Richard Simmons, the action figure, hanging out over there. Carded G.I. Joes. You know me and my love for G.I. Joes. And classics. So we're just going to talk. Hang out. Will you put stuff down and sit in this friggin' seat? For those of you that watch the videos, people have started a new drinking game where they take a shot every time Bradley wanders off. Whilst I'm asking them a question, gets up and wanders off completely. People now take shots. There are a lot of inebriated people out there. And it's all your fault. All your fault. Why don't you show them what you just found of mine that you like to play with? Hestrix. I'm not big into the Hestrix. I think they're cool looking. I'm not a big collector of them, but this one I loved. It has the little spaceship. And then show them what the spaceship does. Fucking badass, right? Badass. So cool. So that's the reason why I have that one. And I found it cheap. So now it lives down here in the collection that barely gets touched or played with anymore. What else? Could you put Hulk Hogan back, please?
Fine. Can I keep him?
No, but just put him back. So, yeah, as you can see, I got some space, and I'm still working on where to put everything. I got some Jaws stuff. I have a whole bunch of McDonald's stuff. Don't touch them. Oh, yeah, show me the two hotcakes. You want to see something cool? You know how back in the 80s they had those transforming, you know, chicken nuggets and stuff? Here, grab a couple of them. Let's show a couple of them off. Just make sure you put them.
You told me this time. This will be wonderful.
You were already going. I just gave you a mission. All right, so I don't know how to transform these. As you know, I suck with transformers. Even these, which have like one move, I can't freaking do it. Something like that. Like that lifts up, and that's all. And it has some little arms. It was an ice cream cone. Now it's a freaking blue tortoise. And now it's an ice cream cone again. What does the Big Mac turn into? It's got like legs and a tail, which the real one might. And it turns into an orange guy. Yeah, silly, but I love these. And I have the whole set. But I just noticed something the other day. Oh, look at it. Yeah, the milkshake or whatever it is, like a pterodactyl or some bullshit.
Caca.
I'm pretty sure they didn't say caca. I mean, I'm no paleontologist by any means.
I am. They said caca.
All right, now this is what's cool. All right, I just noticed. I did not know this.
Oh, wait. Oh.
Here is hotcakes and sausage. Here's fucking hotcakes. Oh. I had no idea there were two different ones.
There's two different ones?
Yeah, they're like brothers or some shit.
What?
Yeah, watch this. Bailey, hold this one so that they can see it. Don't move it. I'm going to transform this one, the big old 2 points of articulation it has. So some wings come out and a head, right? The wings are there. There's like a little tail. So that's the hotcakes now, and I did not know this was such a thing. I thought I had the whole collection until I realized there was a hotcakes and a sausage. Again, not very, you know, not many ways to move it around. But look at that. There's hotcakes and hotcakes and sausage. I was yesterday years old when I figured that out. Literally, I had no idea that there were two separate ones. And boom, hotcakes. I'm so fucking excited.
I was just thinking.
To find out that there was a hotcakes and a hotcakes and sausage. And what is this guy? Oh, just like our plain old cheeseburger. Nothing major, right? Look at this. 1 point, boop, open, transformed into some bullshit. Look at that. All right, put them back. All right, well, brother, you're messing up my client. I didn't say to bring the whole collection over. I do have all of them, by the way. Now, especially, not knowing there was a hotcakes and a hotcakes and sausage.
There is?
The French fries, just his head goes back and he's got eyeballs. That's about all that happens there. There might be something else, but...
Oh, yeah. I have one that I want to show them.
French fries. There, all right, here, put this one back. Make sure the hotcakes and the hotcakes and sausage are up front. Ooh, I love this one, too. Chicken McNuggets. Not only do I love Chicken McNuggets, but I love this toy. I just can't transform it very well. The Happy Meal turns into a dinosaur.
Rawr.
Rawr. Rawr.
Shut up, Dad.
And I think these arms come out, but I suck. Fuck them. There. Oh, nope. Oh, ooh. Yeah, I can't get that other side out, but that's what the side looks like. He's got a green head. He's got that Chicken McNugget dinosaurs. But these transforming McDonald's are super cool. I have a whole bunch of them over there. Take a shot. He's gone. He left completely. We were talking about, he's gone. Put this back over there. Welcome back. Put the put those back.
Trade you.
Trade me what? Those are mine.
Yeah,
no. What do you, how do you trade me my own? I don't get it. All right, will you put those back, please?
I'll play with them.
No, we're not here to play. We're showing them all the cool stuff.
Let's show them this stuff.
Ooh, show them the new board game I got.
Which one?
It's right there on the table.
Where?
You haven't even put it away yet.
I have what? This one?
Yes. Yeah, the only board game there. There's one board game over there.
Which one is the jump?
Dun, 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 dun. Dun, dun, dun. The A-Team board game. It's going to go somewhere in this area. Highly presented. A-Team board game. Here, Brad, could you... He's gone.
What did
it say? Here, put that back over there.
Here it is.
What else can we show? Oh, what's it? Oh, the flag's too big. No, that's...
Show.
That's something to show.
Yeah,
we, you know, we've done the videos customizing the LGNs and stripping the paint off and repainting them. Sometimes we do goofy things for fun. We made a Jesse Ventura, and we had like a Mattel something cane.
Ultimate
cake.
Edition cane.
But look how cool it looks on Jesse the Body. Not bad, right? Just messing around in the basement, bored. There was no school that day. All right, Bradley, put this back, and let's show them. Ooh, let's show them the new superpowers that are out.
Ooh.
Ooh, you guys know if Todd McFarlane did this. Todd McFarlane did the superpowers. Yay! We got them all. I walked into my local Walmart, which is weird, and they had every one of them times six. So I bought every one of them times five. So I left some for you, but I needed them. So. Bradley, will you put the label maker down? He's making labels while we're making a video for you. Well, Bradley, will you hand me the superpowers?
I got the best label.
I'm running out of battery over here.
Show them this label.
No, I'm not showing them that label. It's a family show, for fuck's sake. So we got Hal Jordan, the Green Lantern. Boom. Batman.
Supermobile.
Superman.
Supermobile.
Supermobile. Darkseid. Batman.
Between.
Between. Get yourself a between. If you could. Brad, hand me, there's another one right there. What is it? What is that one? What is that?
Between.
It's another between. I should have two Supermans. Don't I? I thought I had two Supermans.
Superman.
Or do I just have two Batmans?
Yeah,
I didn't really buy five of everyone. I was just pulling your hairs. But I did get a couple of certain ones because I want to open some. And that'll be the next unboxing. Check out this packaging. Look at that.
That's cool.
That's amazing. And the display they came on, I almost fainted when I saw the damn thing. The between.
I love
that. It says it right there. It's a between.
It's a between.
Literally says it. I put that on the counter. And then put the supermobile. Oh! The supermobile. Put that on
supermobile.
Put that next to Jesus Christ, the action figure. And I love the McFarlane. Again, Todd McFarlane, you son of a bitch. You're raiding my wallet. You keep putting things out that I cannot say no to. Batman 66 is one of them. I finally found Mr. Freeze. Love Mr. Freeze, waiting for Egghead Todd. Where's my Egghead Todd? You're doing great, by the way, you son of a bitch. My wallet's paying for it, but you're doing awesome. You're coming up with all the shit I love. You do anything with LGN wrestling, and so help me God, I'll find you. Because I would have to buy all that, too. And you're just killing my wallet, my bank account, and Bradley's college fund.
I had a college fund?
You did, until Todd McFarlane came out with all this cool shit. Now you don't. Your college fund's right there, ripped up on that shelf with the Batmobile and the Batcave from 66.
And the between.
The between and all the superpowers. Oh, Todd McFarlane, you nasty, nasty person, you. Oh, you want to open up a pack of hockey? How random is that? Did you wander off again?
Yes.
How many drunk people are out there right now? Leave comments if you could type.
If you could type.
Fuck. What do we have here? 1990 Topps hockey. All right. There's a whole box of these. What do you... Open it up.
Eat the gum.
Don't eat the gum. Do not eat the gum. Right. Oh, God. That's gross.
All right. I eat it, so...
Oh, you see the gum? Not Ron Tugnut? Really? His name is Ron Tugnut.
Let me see it. His name is Ron Tugnut.
I had that same laugh when I was 12, and you would think he's 12.
No.
Because he's laughing at the same way I did when I was 12. My favorite team. A lot of people know this. Obviously, I'm a huge Sabres fan. Sabres, I bleed gold blue, but... It's a little secret. I love the Hartford Whalers, even though they don't exist anymore. Ron Francis, my favorite. One of these days, I'll tell you the story about how I got in a bar fight with some Hartford Whalers when I was still in high school. And I was in a bar fighting with the Hartford Whalers. Wayne Gretzky for the Kings. That's a pull, bub.
Oh.
Look at that. You picked a good pack. Oh, more Whalers. Yvonne Corvo. Tim Kerr.
It was Ron Tug.
Gary Lehman. I actually met him. Super cool guy. I asked him for his autograph. He's like, but I'm not a Saber. I'm like, you're still cool anyway. And he gave me his autograph. He's like, thanks, man.
That's cool.
And he had the most rockin' mullet in 1990. 89-90. The man had the coolest friggin' mullet. He was damn good, too. Dino Ciccarelli. Finally, some Sabers. Darren Shannon. Not bad. Get some Sabers. He was a top prospect back then. Didn't really work out to be that much of that prospect. Sorry for watching, Darren. Love you still, but... Dale Hunter. Jeff Norton. Oh, another Saber, and guess what it is? Darren Shannon again. Fuck off, Darren. Larry Murphy. Ooh, here's a guy that's awesome. Love this guy. Dropped him. I love him, but I dropped him. Pat Verbeek.
The name is...
Look at the beak on that guy.
Damn, he has a big beak.
Damn. Oh, Gary Suter. I think he still plays it. Old something. Oh, awesome goalie. The Minnesota North Stars, Bradley.
Oh.
Before they were the Dallas Stars, they were the Minnesota North Stars. I love the Minnesota North Stars. Do not like the Dallas Stars. I'm all Minnesota North Stars. John Casey. Awesome goalie. Awesome goalie. And, of course, for another team that doesn't exist anymore, my man Ron Tugnuts. Now, Bradley, the Quebec Nordiques. How cool is that jersey?
That is phenomenal.
Where did the Quebec move to? What team are they now?
I know this one.
No,
I know that Whalers moved to Devils.
Nope.
Yeah.
Incorrect. Nope.
Devils?
The Seals moved to the Devils.
Hurricanes, that's what it is.
The Hurricanes, correct.
I didn't know it was red. But Nordiques, I forget.
The Colorado Avalanche.
Yeah.
And I'm still upset with them because they took away the Quebec Nordiques. So I'm just going to wrap the paper around. That's a good one. There's a Wayne Gretzky in it.
For the Kings.
Look, another gum shot. I didn't realize what I just said. Gumshoe. Vladimir Rozhushka.
I did not notice until he said something, Ned.
Brian McClellan. Oh, kick his ass, Seabass. Cam Neely. Remember Dumb and Dumber? Kick his ass, Seabass. Or whatever that was. Yeah, that's Cam Neely.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, he was Seabass. Kick his ass, Seabass. Joe Nieuwendyk. Yes, I love Joe Nieuwendyk. Bob Brook. Don Maloney.
It's phenomenal.
Oh, I love this guy, Tony Granato. John Ogrodnik. No Sabres yet. Paul somebody. Paul Fenton, who gives a fuck. Oh, I love Paul Stastny. Or Peter Stastny. No, I like Paul Stastny. And it's like his brother. He still plays now. But this is Peter. Peter was also, he played for the Nordiques for like a million years.
Oh, shit.
Toronto Maple Leafs. Fuck out of here with that. That guy. Brad Marsh. Oh, Bradley. $2 if you could say that name.
That's probably give it to you. I was hoping you could say it.
Say it.
Nah.
Lou Franceschetti.
Franceschetti.
Leave it to an Italian to say an Italian name. And we are out. That was just a random throw together video. Just so you can get some shit.
Yeah.
And see some of our stuff. Get a couple shots in. For every time Bradley wanders off. Does a bunch of... Retro World Toys and Games.